Hello. In this video, you will learn how to connect documents from your Google Drive or Google Docs directly into D2L. First, we'll start by going to Google Drive. You can get there by clicking on Los Rios Gmail or typing in apps.losrios.edu into your browser. This will take you to the login screen where you will need your W number and your password. Click Login. I'm going to click Cancel so I don't have to reset my password right now. Click on Google Drive. And I am using a Chrome browser. So by default, this is what it looks like. I want to upload a file containing the upload a folder containing the files that I wish to connect in D2L. So I'm going to click New. And since I'm using Chrome, I can upload a whole folder. If I was using Firefox or Internet Explorer, I would only be able to upload a file. I'm going to click Folder Upload. And now I have to find the folder that I wish to upload. Once I find the folder, I will click Upload, and the upload process will begin. Once it's done, I can click Share, and share or get a link to the entire folder. But since I want to link each individual document in D2L, I'm just going to double click on the folder and open up the documents. Next, I'm going to navigate to D2L. Click on the class that I wish to upload the files to. So through Edit Course, you can upload a bunch of documents at once. Once you do so, these documents are in D2L. And if we decide to not use D2L, then it becomes a problem to transfer these files over to the new course management system. So the option I'm going to show you allows you to keep your documents in your Google Drive, so that way they're always there and you have them, and then you just link to them in D2L. So to link, you're going to go to Content. You can either open up one of your HTML documents or create a new file. I generally start each week with some instructions. I'm going to highlight sample file and here's the sample file that I want to link to. I'm going to click Get Link and notice it says only specific people can access this file. I don't want to leave it like that, so I'm going to click my sharing settings. And I'm going to change this so that way anyone with a link can access this file. I'm going to click Save. And I'm going to click Copy this link. I'm going to go back. Insert Quick Link. And select URL. I'm going to paste my link in the URL field. I can leave the title as sample file, and I'm going to click New Window and Insert, and then Publish. And my link is now available for my students. If I want to edit this page, I'll click Edit HTML. And add another file. Go back to my Google Drive. And this time, let's take another look at sharing by opening up the file. I also get the share button up here. I'm going to click Advanced, and notice it looks a little bit different here, but I can click Change and still get the Anyone with a Link option. And now I can share this link in D2L. Once again, I'm going to click New Window, Insert, and Update. You can also link directly under the content area instead of creating an HTML document. You would do this by clicking New, Create a Link, giving it a title, pasting in the URL, and I usually pick Open as an external resource. The negative to this is you cannot tell how long the student is actually viewing your external resource if you do choose this box, but it tends to run into less issues for the user depending on what browser they're using. Then click Create, and let's take a look at what that looks like. So back to content. Here's the link I just created. I'm going to click on it. It's going to open up a new window, and the student will be able to see my presentation. Before we end, let's take a look at the link sharing settings. We have five options. First, you can set it so anyone out there on the internet can view your document. You can set it so they have to have the link. However, your students can share this link with outside folks, and then they will be able to see your document. This is actually the one that I prefer because it makes it easiest for the students. You can set it so that way you have to have your students log in to their Los Rios Google Docs to view your document. However, if you do this, they'll have to log in and then click on your document to view it. If they click on your document, it'll ask them to log in, and then they'll be left to the login screen, and they'll have to click on your link again anyway. You can set it so that way only those in the district with the specific link can view, or you can also add your students to the specific document one by one. Whichever you decide to use, the preferred one that I recommend is Anyone with a Link, and then click Save. If you have any questions, please contact us at The Cove. D2L support is available in person between 10 and 11 a.m. and 2 to 3 p.m. each day. We also offer numerous courses throughout the year. Please feel free to call the phone number 855-321-3232 or contact us via email for support. Thank you.